Welcome to the weekly wind down, a chance to dive into the detail of the biggest news from MCN, get up close and personal with the latest motorbikes, and find out what kit we've been using while we rack up the miles. Find full details of the stories mentioned at Motorcyclenews.com, or get the added perks of becoming a member at the link. This week, we brought you the Bistella 500, a supercharged 10-cylinder two-stroke, hand-built by Czech engineer Marek Foltis. Setting out to build something for which no template existed, Foltis made the engine case, crankshaft, no fewer than 5 Roots-type blower supercharger assemblies, and master conrods on a CNC mill. These were then assembled together with stock parts from vintage Jawa models and mounted to a donor frame. Foltis told MCN that any more than 10 cylinders would mean having to modify the frame, which is why he drew the line there. The bike's incredibly complex exhaust is made from 17 separate sections and took a month to perfect. The result is a 60 brake horsepower bike that is truly one of a kind, but also looks surprisingly natural at first glance. Foltis said of his creation, "One step further in complexity, and I would need magic, not science, to make it work." Chief road tester Michael Neves has been in Abu Dhabi testing the Ducati Diavel V4. Join him now for an up-close look at the new model from the launch.
This is the 2023 Ducati Diavel V4. This bike is completely new. So, obviously, it's got a new engine, V4 Gran Turismo engine, 166 bhp. This is the same engine as you get in the Multistrada. The most impressive thing on this bike is it rides nothing like it looks. So it looks like a big, heavy old cruiser, doesn't it? But nothing could be further from the truth. This bike is a bodybuilder that can run like Usain Bolt. So we haven't ridden this bike in a straight line at all, which sort of tells you everything you need to know about it. It's a fantastic handling bike. So, I mean, it comes in red and black. Black looks absolutely mean. It's fantastic. The reason it's so agile is it's 13 kilos lighter than the old Diavel, and that's down to a number of things, most notably the frame. So it hasn't got a trellis steel frame anymore. It's got a cast aluminium monocoque, a bit like the Monster. So that saves a lot of weight. And the wheels are a smidge lighter, 0.9 of a kilo. But the main thing is because the engine runs backwards, the crank goes backwards, it cancels out the gyroscopic effect of the wheels. So you've got a really light, agile bike, loads of ground clearance as well. You can ride this like a superbike, and it goes like a superbike. The brakes are just astonishing. They've got loads of feel, mega amount of power, and because the bike's long and low, low center of gravity, the way it stops is just incredible. It takes your breath away. Ducati V4s for a little while have had rear cylinder cut at tick over, which stops the heat getting a little bit too much when you're at traffic lights. By the way, it's got really nice detail. Look at that. Look at those rocket launcher pipes. Look at this, like the machined wheels. These are cast alloy wheels, and these there's 112 LEDs in there. Looks fantastic. So anyway, this has got an extended cylinder cut, so at anything below 4000 rpm in second gear and higher, the bike's only running on two cylinders, the two front cylinders. So that again makes the bike really smooth, really docile. That technology comes from MotoGP, where they use it to soften the power where they come out of corners. It helps on fuel consumption. And then over 4,000 RPM, it turns back into a V4 again. Or if you ask for a lot of power, if you actually give it some, then it goes on to four before 4,000 RPM. Under that single seat, it's got it's pillion seat. It's got a retractable grab rail. It's got pillion footrest hangers that swing out, and it's just beautifully made. as it should be, because this bike is 23,500 pounds. But having said that, since 2011, Ducati has sold 45,000 Diavels, so obviously a market for them out there. Loads of electronics, as you'd expect, lean sensitive, traction control, ABS, anti-wheelie, launch control, up and down quick shifter. It's got the lot. This bike is really, really impressive. I didn't think I was going to like it that much. The old Diavel was okay, but it's very cruisery, you know. It's got its time and its place where it's really nice, but you know, it doesn't do an awful lot. Whereas this, you could, you know, it's genuinely sporty. That's the Diavel V4. You can read more about it on MCN.com and on our YouTube channel. But for now, we're about to head out for another little ride.
And finally, we've been reviewing the new and incomprehensibly named Vanucci Vag 4 textile jacket. The Vag forms part of the Vanucci PLUS modular system, which allows the wearer to choose their own combination of weather protection. So this jacket is the water repellent and single A rated component, complete with CE level 2 armour at the elbows and shoulders, and a pocket for back protector. If you want to be completely water and windproof, then you buy the VXR1 membrane jacket, and if you want something warmer, then you add the VXU3 thermal layer. There's also a second waterproof layer you can wear over the top of the lot. The system would be great on long tours and leisure riding, but it's not ideal for winter commuting where we've been testing it. But the biggest problem is that when you add up the price of all the layers, you get to £656.43, which is hardly small change. Thanks for watching the weekly wind on. Let us know what you think in the comments section, and remember to hit like and subscribe so you never miss an episode.